I do want to, you know, kind of ask you about some stuff with ESPN, obviously. You're on the outside now, but when you look at it, you kind of mentioned ESPN as like your ex.
Yeah.
How do you see them right now, on the outside?
I'm grateful. How do I see them as it relates to me?
How do I see them as a company? How do you see them as it relates to you and your professional career? Yep. And then how do you see them as a company?
How do I see them as it relates to my professional career? I see them as the reason I'm sitting here with you right now, the reason you're interested in having me on the show, the reason I have a fancy title at Collaboratory. You know, I appreciate the platform. I appreciate the experience. I appreciate the relationships. I appreciate even how it ended because, okay, going back, let's just stick with the relationship analogy. Truth be told, so somebody told me a long time ago, if you're always talent, you could always be replaced. So in the back of my mind, I always thought about some kind of hybrid or some kind of evolution into an executive role. That was always in the back of my mind. But that said, I did also think about, I'm going to leave this place before they get rid of me. That was always my goal. And I'm into even numbers, like the temperature has to be on an even number on the thermostat. I pump to even numbers, even if it means gas is spewing out of the tank. Doesn't matter. Got to get to zeros at the end of it. Or maybe a multiple of five, something like that. But anyway, sorry,
is
tangent.
Is that an OCD thing?
Probably. Yeah. So anyway, 15 years, 40 years old. So funny. Never knew it would happen like this. But a while back, I started thinking, like, when I'm 40, I want to kind of reassess, you know, what I want to do. And that's when things were going well at ESPN. I'm glad that it ended the way it did, uncomfortably, awkwardly, painfully at times, because much like with a relationship, sometimes they got to break up with you. And it's the best thing that ever happened to you. But you wouldn't have walked away just based off the devil you know, familiarity, comfort, history. You're staying together for the kids, whatever. You got a house in each other's name, whatever it is, right? Likewise, sometimes somebody got to dog you. They got to cheat on you. Shit's got to go bad for you to leave. And then you get to the next person, you're like, oh my God, I'm so glad I got out of that relationship, even though there were some good things about that relationship, because now I'm in a better place that I would not have been. Because the last thing John Skipper told me before he left, he said, Michael, you could be the Kobe Bryant of this place. He was like, you could spend your entire career here. Because again, I had gotten there when I was 25. Mm. So I had grown up there. And I think if not for the way it ended, I really believe that there was a subconscious level of complacency that would have set in. The platform, the status, the salary, the security. You know, we love our house and our neighborhood in Connecticut. I wouldn't have left for a startup. I'd have never been inclined to meet Jamie and discuss the startup with her. I'd have probably been at the 50 year celebration. Maybe I'd have been on stage, maybe, right next to Berman or somebody. So professionally, I'm thankful for everything that happened for me and to me at ESPN. As a company, how do I see him? Well, as competition now, but I also not even competition. I shouldn't say competition. I see them as a buyer, and I see them as somebody that I want to do business with, that I want to develop content that they're inclined to buy. Whether it's for linear ESPN or ESPN Plus or whatever it is, I see them as somebody that I want to be able to go back into those offices as chief content officer and executive vice president and collaborator and say, here, I have this project that I think you'd be interested in buying. So that's professionally how I see them. And as competition, as another entity in the marketplace, I see them as evolving, like all of us have to do. I mean, these streaming wars are changing everything. And so I think, you know, Jimmy Pataro and that team are doing everything they can to really make sure, because ESPN, to its credit, has always, again, been the worldwide leader in sports. And so I think they're trying not only to keep up with the evolution within the industry, but lead the way as best it can when it comes to evolving it within the industry.
But at the same point, you also said that there was no more room for growth for you there.
It was not, no. Yeah. So why not?
No, it just they seem to be maybe on the trajectory that you guys that you are. You said you might want to have them as a buyer, but that they being there in particular, you wouldn't have been able to be as creative.
Oh God, no! But that's specific to me and my circumstances. I mean, obviously, you know, that's a lot to unpack. We're going to need more drinks and more time for that.
Yeah,
but
yeah. Both of those things. Yeah,
but in terms of me, again, I've worn so many hats there. You know, I've been a reporter. I've been an NFL insider. I've been an investigative reporter. I've been a host. I've been an anchor. I've been a personality. I've had my own show. I've anchored sports centers. Like, how much was there for me to do?
Right.
But not just that. Frankly, there weren't a lot of opportunities available to me at this point for whatever reason, they did not make the type of opportunities available to me that interested me or excited me in terms of continuing my relationship there. So it was a good time. It was a good time for both of us to part ways. I think, you know, I had, look, man, somebody also said everything ends badly, otherwise it wouldn't end. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, there's no animus by any means, because I'm thankful, because again, if not in that position that I was in, that position of being able to step back from the daily grind, that hamster wheel, get off that ride and actually look around and say, wait, is this the park I want to be in, or do I want to go to another spot, or what do I want to do? Because those 15 years flew by. Mm-hmm. I'm not in a position where I am now where I'm freer and more energized and more excited to go to work than I've ever been.
Right.